Welcome to the fascinating world of open source intelligence, or OSINT for short. Imagine a vast ocean of publicly accessible information, just waiting to be explored. OSINT is all about diving into that ocean, gathering data from sources like social media, websites, search engines, and public databases. Oh, and before we dive deeper, I made this insane 40-page PDF with over 1,000 OSINT tools. Everything from social media tools to the same stuff the FBI uses. You can find it in my private community, the link's in the description. Honestly, you can even grab it for free if you want. And hey, if you're into ethical hacking, we've got some killer courses that break everything down step by step. Anyway, let's get back to exploring the power of OSINT. You'd be amazed at the sheer volume of valuable information freely available to anyone with the skills to uncover it. By using OSINT techniques, you can uncover patterns, track behaviors, and even make predictions about the future. Companies use it to strengthen their defenses against cyber threats. Law enforcement agencies rely on it for investigations, and cybersecurity experts leverage it to identify vulnerabilities before attackers do. Always use OSINT ethically, respect privacy laws, and understand the boundaries of legal data collection. Let's start with Google dorking, often referred to as search engines on steroids. At first glance, Google seems simple. You type in a query, and it spits out results. But there's a hidden layer of complexity beneath the surface. Google dorking lets you use advanced search operators to dig deeper, uncovering data that's otherwise hidden or difficult to find. For example, if you're looking for financial reports on Microsoft, you could type financial report site Microsoft.com file type PDF into Google. This command narrows your search to PDF files containing the term financial report, specifically from Microsoft's website. Operators like site search within a specific website, in title, looks for keywords in titles, and in URL, focuses on terms in URLs. With these tools, you can find everything from exposed documents to login pages. Next up is the Harvester, a tool designed to gather data like email addresses, IPs, and subdomains. A simple command like theharvester-d kali.org-bbing will instruct the tool to query Bing for data related to kali.org. Within moments, you'll have a list of publicly accessible emails, IP addresses, and other details. It's quick, efficient, and incredibly effective for initial reconnaissance. Then, there's EXIF tool, which specializes in extracting metadata. Metadata is like the fingerprints of a file, revealing details such as the author of a document, the software used to create it, or even the location where a photo was taken. For example, if you have an image file, running the command exiftoolfile.jpg will display all its metadata. This can be invaluable in investigations, helping you trace the origin of a file or uncover hidden clues. However, metadata can sometimes contain sensitive information, so handle it with care and respect the privacy of individuals. Photon, on the other hand, is your go-to for automating information collection from websites. Manual data gathering can be tedious, especially for large sites. Photon simplifies this by crawling through a target URL and gathering links, images, emails, and more. For instance, this command instructs Photon to crawl the specified site and store all collected data in an output folder. Whether you're analyzing a corporate website or conducting research, Photon can save you hours of work while ensuring you don't miss critical information. If you're investigating usernames across platforms, Sherlock is your best friend. This tool searches for usernames on hundreds of websites, from social media platforms to obscure forums. Suppose you're tracking someone with the username CyberFlow. Running Python 3 Sherlock CyberFlow will reveal whether that username is registered on platforms like Twitter, Instagram, or Facebook. This is particularly useful for understanding someone's online presence or conducting security assessments. It's efficient and gives you a clear picture of where an entity might be active online. For visualizing relationships, Maltego offers a unique edge. It's a tool that maps connections between people, companies, and entities. Using Maltego's transforms, you can search across multiple data sources and create a visual representation of how different elements relate to one another. Imagine investigating a network of companies and uncovering shared ownership or partnerships. Maltego makes these connections tangible, helping you see the bigger picture. It's a favorite among cybersecurity experts and law enforcement agencies for mapping complex networks. Finally, we have Shodan, a search engine tailored for finding internet-connected devices. Whether it's webcams, routers, or servers, Shodan allows you to search by IP address, location, or device type. If you're a cybersecurity professional, Shodan helps identify exposed devices that might be vulnerable to attacks. With an account, you can use its powerful filters to locate specific types of devices and analyze their security posture. It's a must-have tool for anyone serious about monitoring and protecting IoT devices. OSINT is a treasure trove of opportunities, but it demands responsibility. The tools we've discussed, Google Dorking, The Harvester, EXIF Tool, Photon, Sherlock, Maltego, and Shodan, are powerful allies in gathering public information. Whether you're conducting research, improving cybersecurity, or investigating, always respect the boundaries of privacy and the law. Remember, OSINT is not just about finding data, it's about using it to make the world a safer, smarter place.